Are the Clippers the best team in L.A.?
The Clippers are the best team in L.A. because they're the tougher team in L.A. Mm. Yeah, to me, it's not LeBron and Kawhi. It's the other guys. And the other guys, for me, for the Clippers, just stepped up. Patrick Beverley, he kind of epitomizes what the Clippers are all about, that toughness, that hard outer shell. Montrezl Harrell, the same thing, his ability to make plays, rim run. I look at the Clippers, they seem like they have more invested and more competitive.
Grittier team right now. And these two teams played an opening night, I believe. And the Clippers beat them in that game as well. And you look at this team. Kawhi's one of the best defensive players in basketball. Paul George, one of the best defensive players in basketball. Patrick Beverley, one of the toughest defensive players in basketball. There's a theme there. And it seems like it pervades the way they play. And they've been able to take it to the Lakers. And they've been the more impressive team so far this season.
Guys, I feel like the Lakers gave this one away. I mean, they had a double-digit lead, 15 points. They allowed the Clippers to clip back into the game. I will say this, though. Thinking future forward, do the Lakers need a guy like Andre Iguodala to help spell some rest for LeBron James and garner the likes of Kawhi, Paul George, Lou Will, because they have so much firepower with the Clippers?
Jay, well, it's always good to add a piece, a competitive piece, a championship piece. Mm-hmm. I think the bigger thing is in the fourth quarter, Anthony Davis, he didn't get touches. I mean, Kentavious Caldwell-Pope got more touches. Rajon Rondo got more touches. LeBron James got more touches. Look, the best player on the Lakers is not LeBron James. It's Anthony Davis. And when the game is on the line, that dude has got to get touches.
Well, he may now have the chance to assert himself if this groin injury is what it sounds like, and the Lakers want to be very careful about it and give him some time off. And he had a groin injury last year, and it seemed to linger. And keep in mind, LeBron James is turning 35 years old next week. 35. So these injuries don't heal quicker. They linger longer.
Father time? Undefeated?
It's just the natural course of events. And so if that's the case, if LeBron is missing time, that gives Anthony Davis a chance to integrate himself further into this offense with this team. They become more reliant on him. Maybe it turns into exactly what you're saying.
How about your thoughts on the fact that LeBron James, after the game, stated to the public that he re-aggravated his groin after a loss, though? I mean, does that kind of seem like – is that something that you say, you do? I know you're trying to be transparent, but it seems like it's an excuse.
Yeah, like to me, if I was LeBron James, you tip the hat and say, you know what, in this moment in time, the Clippers were really good. I'll tell you, just like you said that, Jay Will, how about on the other side, Kawhi Leonard? He acted like he just beat the Knicks. I mean, it was like just another game. Ho, hum, yeah, you know what?
That's him,
Christmas,
though. That's him, though.
Let's go and just – he just walked off the court like this is just the next game. Who do we have next? This is not going to win us a championship. We're not worried about being the champions of L.A. We're worried about being NBA champions. I love the way Kawhi Leonard handled it. LeBron – a little disappointed because he doesn't need to say that. We know how good he is. And you know what? Say Patrick Beverley had his hands above the ball, contested the shot. Hey, made a great play on the last
one. Hey, here's my question. What was Patrick Beverley doing wearing that Chicago Blackhawks hat? What was that about?
It's a Chicago thing. That's where him and AD are from. Hey, look, in order to find out more about LeBron James' injury, let's check in with our own Dave McMahon.
It hit the same part of his body that had been affecting him since he missed that last game against Denver. He told us that it set him back those 5 days of rest and recovery he had coming into this game. He's back to square one. And there are people within the Lakers organization that are already encouraging LeBron to take this injury very serious and make sure he's 100% and not to push it and come back before he feels 100%. So certainly there's a possibility that we could see LeBron have some more games that he has to miss coming up.
Can't believe I'm going to say this. Are we going to have to load manage LeBron?
Is this
what Frank Vogel is going to have to do?
This year?
Risk mitigation for LeBron James.
You love the load management.
I love it. You know I love it.
Shefty, there's a difference between injured and inconvenienced. Like, when you're talking about LeBron James, if you are inconvenienced, you are injured. Because for the Lakers to win a championship, and let's face it, this team has been put together to win a championship, you need the best of LeBron James. So I'm not sure if it's load management. I don't call it load management. He's hurt. He's injured. And if he's inconvenienced, that is an injury because, big picture, they need that.
And they're going to err to the side of caution because of his age. They're not going to rush him back. There's no need to rush him back. They want him healthy in the spring. They don't need him healthy in the winter. It's a long-term view with him. It's a big, long-term play. So, again, it's not load management.
No, Steffi, I get it.
It's taking your time with a guy who's going to be 35 years old next week.
Here's the thing, though. We are playing for playoff seeding. And I think
what does that mean?
It means a lot.
No.
It means a lot.
His very best, Jay Will. Can he go anywhere and win?
Yes.
Yes.
Like, right. Here's the thing. Football right now, they're not playing Lamar Jackson.
No.
Right?
But they're locked in to the number one seed.
Yeah.
But guys, we're only a third of the way through the season, though,
guys. But they're locked in. Exactly. And if you want LeBron down the stretch, look, I'm not a big load management guy because I think that you're getting paid an obscene amount of money, all right, to do a job. Like, you don't have load management.
So let me ask you.
You wake up every day and go to work. So, but if you're trying to win a championship, you need that dude at 100% healthy.
He gets load managed in the NBA Finals basketball season, though, a little bit. Let me ask you this question, though.
With his 16
do the Lakers votes. Do the Lakers need to make a move to find somebody else that can create shots? It seems like Rajon Rondo can do that, but he's a liability offensively at the end of ball games because he can't shoot.
I think they need one more guy to take a little bit of pressure on them. They need another perimeter player that either can be a defensive stopper that can defend multiple positions or a guy that can make a play for himself and for others.
Do they have the assets to go give up? The picks, the players, the cap space? Do they have all that to go get another guy?
It doesn't look – I mean, I tried to put out a tweet last night saying they should go for Drew Holiday, and I got destroyed on Twitter. I was like, you're right. They don't have the assets to do so. That's the problem.
A good player obviously costs something.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN Plus right now.